Right, our last country to present is our dear friend S.P. Shah from India. So he'll talk a little bit about another big market that's boomed the last couple of years.
Good morning, friends. I'm grateful to Ed Tonkin, Albert, Mr. Wade, and Bill Freddy, President Brady, to give me an opportunity to be here and represent the automobile industry situation and the likely progress in the next few years. Automobile industry in India is emerging at a very, very fast rate, and we are very delighted with the government support in all respect. Now, whenever we look at the country and the car per 1,000 people, we always feel that what are the opportunities we have. As on date, we have only 10 cars for 1,000 people. And with the population of 1.3 billion people, we have a great opportunity. Our neighbor friends, China, they have almost about 27 cars per 1,000. This is the opportunity what we will have. Now, government of India is very, very active to ensure to give a better support to the car manufacturers. We have a tremendous reforms for exports, and the government is giving assistance to people, manufacturers. Government is also very keen that India's economy should be developed at a very fast rate. We have a continuous GDP growth of about 8%, and which is going to continue for a much longer period of time. The greatest growth drivers in India are the working population is very high, sound urbanization, then government various steps. Sorry, I can't hear. Can I see you?
Yeah.
Yeah. My apologies. Working population, rapid urbanization, and skilled manpower which is available in the country, we are having the largest number of engineers in the world. The booming rural market, we have about 600,000 villages, and those are the great potentiality for selling cars, two-wheelers, as well as the commercial vehicle. As on date, we are the largest manufacturer of three-wheelers in the world. We are also the second largest two-wheeler manufacturer in the world. The car manufacturers, we are the second largest, and very shortly, we'll be the small car, largest car manufacturer in the world. We are the third largest car manufacturer in light commercial vehicles. Almost every car manufacturer in the world, they have a plant in India, the facilities in India, and they are increasing the production. In April, January to December, we see the statistics. We are the second largest car manufacturer in the world next to China. China is 39% and we are 32%. As far as the commercial vehicles are concerned, we have produced more than the China has produced. We are like always comparing our production, market, requirements with China, because all over the world, people are thinking what China is doing. Can we do better than China, or can we do similar to China? So my statistics and comparison is as good as for China, because our population of China, India is more or less the same. The global major entering in India leverage several advantages what they have. Product development capabilities are very high in India because of large number of engineers getting education in India. High quality standards, proximity in market. India domestic market is good, as well as the potentiality for export to neighboring countries is also very high. Availability of skilled manpower at a reasonably lower rate. And this is the greatest advantage to all the manufacturers. Large growing domestic market. We are producing more for the domestic market than export. Because we are not worried about international crisis, good or bad. If we have a domestic market strong, we can survive at a much greater rate. And that is the reason we are more dependent on the domestic market. All the manufacturers have started putting plants in India, considering export potentiality. All major players in the world have started research and development centers in India because they feel the talented engineers are available in India. The cost of engineer is comparatively much lower. People can speak English, understand English, and explain the things better. Almost all manufacturers in the world, they feel let us encourage Indian talent, take the advantage, and be the global player. Indian global in auto industry. 2014 could be among the five vehicle producers in the world. Indian engineers have established their capabilities in research and development department by manufacturing innovation and producing the cheapest four-seater car in the world, and that is called Nano. It has become most popular in India with the ability of Tata organization, the largest organization in country. They will produce more and more Nano small car, which people in the world can afford at a much reasonable price. R&D centers by leading car manufacturer. Every year we are increasing more and more participation from international manufacturers. International car manufacturers prefer India as a hub to develop, produce, and export. Develop because of the talent, produce because of the domestic consumption, and export because of the neighboring proximity we have. Tata Nano received the world's oldest and most coveted Chicago Award recently. It appears that USA might be the importer of cars because of the local cost. Global recognition. In last 3 months, the President of USA, President of France, President of Russia, President of China, President of UK with a large delegation, they visited India not only to see Taj Mahal, but to see what they can do in India. Every president visited with the largest possible industrial delegation. They feel India is a safe market, can understand English properly, legal norms are internationally acceptable, and that is the opportunity that all over the world people are looking for. And we will continue to support all the manufacturers in the world to explore the local talent, local market. All car manufacturers in the world, you name from Suzuki to Toyota, the latest car are being marketed in India. They feel that India is a market to test the car, to service the car, and sell the car. India is not the market for cheap car. India is the market for the Rolls-Royce as well as the smaller car. The proximity and the purchase power in India is increasing substantially. So all over the world, car manufacturer, they want to produce the best car available. I am told recently Toyota introduced Etios car. They took 3 years to study the market. They examined and met thousands of people in India. Now they feel that this car could be the best car for the BRIC countries.
Just a couple questions on India. SP, one of the difficulties is infrastructure, right? And that's something that the government has spent a lot of money on to support the growing vehicle population. How is that going? I mean, there's some stats about the number of roads that are being added.
See, government of India took a very wise decision to increase the road length. We were having a very meager road length. Now, recently, when President Obama visited India, they decided that $3 trillion will be spent on the infrastructure development. Road requirement is like a river. You always find the ways, roads. It's not that the roads in India are all bad or not motorable. They are not good like turnpikes and highways or autobahns in all over the world. But cars are being produced. Last year we sold 2.3 million cars. And there are still cars on the road. Today, unfortunately for the buyer, cars are not available. They are on the waiting list. I'm sure government will take appropriate steps and better roads will be available and more people will be in a position to drive comfortably.
And then lastly, you know, the Nano was in the news, you know, when it was first launched. Any update on how Nano is doing there and their plans to export around the world?
See, Nano initially, people thought it will be a small car, will be a miserable car. One or two accidents takes place. This is the only car developed by Indian engineers, 100% Indian. To make a car in the world at $2,000, one of the manufacturers announced publicly that people should know what car is. When the car was produced on the road, it was a fantastic car. Teething troubles are always there. When we are born, when we start walking, we always have a couple of falls. So I'm confident the Tata organization, the largest organization in the country, they'll maintain the respect, they'll carry out the modification required, and that will be the car for the future for the developing countries. And I'm sure Tata will take appropriate steps.
Thank you very much.